Hey, somebody there? You okay? Hey, guy. Hey, you all right? Hey, my man. Hello.
621?
Who's this?
Who is this?
System alert. Voice mismatch.
We have a protocol breach. 621 in San Francisco is not active. This is not 621 on the phone.
No, this isn't 621. Listen, who's this? Hello?
Tell me your name.
Sean Flynn.
Sean Flynn? I'm Miranda Zero. And you are on the global frequency.
Global frequency?
The global frequency.
Yeah, I've seen the news. Everybody's heard of you. It's just the global frequency's an urban legend.
Well, that's a step up. We're usually a fairy tale.
The global frequency is real. We are an independent, covert intelligence group. Yet somehow, you've just picked up one of our phones.
Sean, I'm Aleph, the nice one. Look, we need you to show us what you're looking at. There's a camera inside the phone.
Hi.
David Riggs. He worked for me. And he was a friend.
I'm sorry about that.
Why isn't this guy running away screaming?
What is this?
We've been satellite tracking small, intense bursts of strange radiation for about 2 months now.
2 weeks ago, we could barely detect these flare-ups. Now they're spiking 2 or 3 times a day and doing that.
Whatever the source is, it's getting worse faster.
Now, according to our projections, these blasts will become big enough to rip apart entire city blocks within 55 minutes. Who's on the West Coast? Particle physics, the heavies.
There's only one person on the frequency even close to being smart enough for that.
Dr. Finch.
No. Super strength solution in these conditions does not yield 39 dimensions. 955?
Dr. Katrina Finch, you are on the global frequency.
How bad is it?
I'm uploading data into your phone as fast as I can get it in.
I'm on my way.
Mr. Flynn, you happen to see a
metallic case nearby?
Yeah, hold on. What about it?
I need you to collect data from the scene.
No, There's half a guy here and alpha.
Aleph.
Whatever girl said, radiation.
One time.
55 minutes and counting before hundreds, possibly thousands of people die. So you have a choice. So you can stay on the line and make a difference. Or you can hang up and walk away. Yes, it always is. 54 minutes, Mr. Flynn.
All right, look, I'll stay here until somebody else gets here, but that's it.
He's used to crisis, whoever he is.
Okay, so he's a cop. Ex-cop. Curiouser and curiouser.
I think we just got insanely lucky.
Now, just change the flash memory and extend that little gray tube. It detects the radiation intensity.
Damn it. Son of a...
Detach the earpiece from the bottom of the phone and then clip it to your belt.
Look, can I ask you something? You're telling me that this happens all the time.
Huh. If you even knew just how many ultra-secret nightmares the government was covering up, you would never sleep again. Just curl up under your bed, weeping and waiting for the inevitable hellish apocalypse.
Thanks, thank you.
Okay, your expert has arrived, Dr. Finch.
I'm saved. Hey, look, you'll be okay. My name's Sean.
The case, could you? Wow. Whoa. Aleph?
We have EM detritus. I
swear there's some Hawking radiation.
Radiation again.
Good.
These energy blast patterns aren't random. They're organized like brain waves or biologics.
What kind of explosive is this? C4, fuel air?
Not what? Who? A person is doing this.
You've got the magic. It makes me glow so much. It rings a bell. The magic
People don't melt sidewalks, okay? Nobody can do that. I don't believe it.
The universe doesn't care what you believe. It doesn't have to make sense to you. It just has to make sense. Sorry for throwing up on you.
Was this you being nice to me?
Yes. The windows in the alley weren't broken. Did you notice that?
Kinda focused on the corpse.
All that destruction and then the windows were broken. There's a pattern.
Yep, the previous flare-ups are in tight little clusters.
Riggs a cop?
Yes, ex-NYPD.
Look, I know what Riggs was doing here. He had this street under surveillance. Yeah, a couple hours from the trash. But he was watching somebody for hours. Somebody works in a building here. Okay, he's a pro. He comes for coffee. But he wouldn't let the subject out of his sight. That building, 275 Kingman, is the only one with the door visible from both the alley and the coffee cart. Riggs was surprised.
Okay, he didn't lure the suspect to the alley.
Suspect cut through the alley on his own. Ask me why, Kate.
Katrina, actually.
Alley's a shortcut home after work. Where's the mass transit?
Bus station, trolley, all south of you.
Suspect's within walking distance. North side of the alley.
The first flares are right there.
Anybody live in the center of that pattern also works at 275 Kingman?
Spank me. He did it.
Maybe.
We must locate the subject now.
I'll go. Thank you. Nice meeting you. Yeah.
Thank you very much, Mr. Flynn.
She has a plan, right?
Probably not.
You got a PhD in weird science?
6. Actually, doctorates. I was in university when I was 13. Particle physics, astrophysics, electrical engineering, biochemical engineering, genetics, biomaterials.
Biomaterials?
Combining organic and non-organic materials together, like cybernetics or bionics, but with nanotechnology, you know.
I know that was the end of the sentence because you stopped talking.
Well, then some neurology, epidemiology.
How'd you have time for life?
I had life.
Oh, yeah, no, I'm just saying.
I went out.
Good for you.
I had boyfriends. Many boyfriends.
Hey.
Many.
The door was open.
Huh? Subtle.
You went to college. I joined the Marines.
What did you learn in the Marines?
I like simple answers, and I have an elevated capacity for violence.
Is that useful?
You'd be surprised. I think this Jenkins is a good guy.
No.
Well, there's a schedule on the fridge. He volunteers at the local library. $50 a month to an animal shelter. Bad guys don't like dogs.
Hitler did.
Seizures are getting worse. They're days. I can feel it clawing at my brain from inside. It's causing severe nosebleeds.
I don't want to hurt anyone. Yet, not yet!
Oh, no!
Energy field he sets up, it doesn't interact well with liquids. Glass. The glass shower. On a molecular level, glass is a liquid.
Nuh-uh.
Uh-huh. Huh.
Hey, guy, you still there?
Windows are intact, just like in the alley.
Wow, we would have been.
You saved our lives.
Five.
Yes.
You're not melted.
Jenkins had some sort of seizure. I don't know how he's doing it, but Jenkins is the source.
His name isn't Jenkins.
Explain.
Guy shouted at us in Russian. Your body's frying. You don't scream out in your second language. I took high school French. When I got shot, I didn't start yelling about the bibliothèque in my crayon jaune.
You have a yellow pencil?
Yep, and it's Trey Grove.
You were shot?
Richard Jenkins is... Vladimir Putekin. Passport CCCP, old school Soviet Union, all the way.
Scan it.
Mr. Flynn, you are turning out to be one hell of a detective.
Thanks, and stop calling me Mr. Flynn. You sound like my fifth grade English teacher and you're pissing me off.
What's he doing and how's he doing it?
Sean, listen up. This is the cool part. Welcome to the global frequency.
Hey there, Trey, Trey.
Collins Kaskar, du er på global frequency. Jeg har husket så fil, du kan gennem lese. Audrey McGovern, you're on the global frequency. I have satellite data for you to look at.
José Carrillo, usted está conectado a la frecuencia global. Francesco Riccardi, tú se conectado en la frecuencia global.
Takawa Hiro-san, Anatoa, Robo Frequencini, Omukahai Shimatsu.
I have Nadia Kroshin from Small Links. Nadia tracked Jenkins, or as we know his Russian name.
Putekin.
Putekin was Soviet Army. Nothing special until his file notes. He tested high on a Graf Zimmer test. He disappeared after that.
If I may.
Dr. Kane, medical historian, retired?
Dr. Elias Graf Zimmer was disbarred after intrusive medical experiments attempting to prove the existence of psychic phenomena among African Americans in the late 1950s.
Intrusive?
He drilled into their heads.
Who do we have on paranormal research in the Soviet Union, late 60s, early 70s?
Danny Foyle, archivist, Library of Congress.
The Fortean Times had copies of KGB files from that decade, no names, but Nadia sent me Jenkins, Putekin's serial number. Now, it matches up to something called Operation Mercury. Operation Mercury was a major part of the Soviet Army's psychic research program.
Ooh, this guy's...
No, it's true. During the 1970s, the Soviets had as much money invested in psychic research as they did their space program.
Everyone, thank you. You know how much this means.
Toc, merci beaucoup. Gracias, toda.
Everybody knows the agencies that are supposed to protect us never talk to each other. So some of the best, scariest intelligence agents solve the problem. Now they spy on the spies. They get all the pieces, they put them together, and they stop whatever's coming, whatever the cost.
But who are these people, I mean?
Miranda knew with all the secret horrors out there, no one group could solve every problem. So if you are the best at what you do, no matter how strange or obscure or mundane, one day Miranda Zero appears on your door and hands you the phone. That means that what you do will save lives. You are needed. I'm needed. You never know who's on the global frequency.
Do we have anything or anyone left over from Project Mercury?
All of the scientists on the roster are dead. Oh. Except for Oskar Sergeyev, After the collapse of the Soviet Union, he was one of the scientists the NSA grabbed because of the value of his research. He was then brought to the States, but no record of him after that.
If the NSA has Sergeyev, I have an idea of where he might be.
Dr. Finch and Mr. Sean,
I'm depending on you to track Jenkins on the ground.
He's on foot, now we're on foot. We might be able to pick up his tracks. Okay. I've seen him do the thing. I'll give you that, but he's not doing it with his brain. The guy's got a bomb or something.
So science isn't real unless it's something you can punch or kick?
Kick test is a very good test.
Barry Julian?
Don't eat the Kung Pao chicken, Barry. It's mine.
Look. I can be fired for talking to you, all right?
I can be fired for even knowing you exist.
Oh, stop panicking. You're an NSA agent. Have a little dignity. Hang up on me. I will kill your entire family.
Why won't you leave me alone?
Because we're friends, Barry. Oskar Sergeyev, Russian scientist. We would have grabbed him in the mid-90s after the Soviet collapse. I believe he's in one of the three secure lockdowns there.
The National Security Agency has no such illegal facilities.
Barry, I designed those illegal facilities. Which one is it?
He's in Zulu.
Thank you. Don't even dream of telling them I'm coming. Aleph.
NSA lockdown, codename Zulu. I'm going in.
There's an automatic lockdown timer. Once the front door opens, all that security has to be bypassed in less than 60 seconds.
Well, this should be very interesting.
I can hack it.
No need. I left a back door code.
When I designed it.
What is it?
Your birthday.
Oh, that's so sweet. 55 seconds.
Ma'am? Gotta see some ID.
Aleph, left or right?
Left.
There's a keyboard access to the retinal scanner.
Oops.
Did you just say...
Use the phone, I'll decrypt.
Unauthorized entry.
Sector 6, level 3.
Shoot the hell out of it.
Yes, sir.
Go, move, move!
Oskar Sergeyev?
Yeah.
I'd like to talk to you about Project Mercury.
He's putting out way more power than his brain can generate.
He's not doing this with his brain.
Okay, Jenkins is showing up on satellites.
He's lit up like a city block.
You're right. Exactly like a city block. He's interfacing.
Skimming off the city electrical grid.
Yep. Part of the early flare-ups were voltage drops in the San Francisco power line.
Can we track him that way?
Ah, got him. Big power variant, 3 blocks south of you, down by the waterfront.
He's trying to save innocent lives. You saw how upset he was when he started to melt down with us in the room. Jenkins doesn't want to hurt anybody. He's a good guy.
Oh, there's no way for you to know that.
Come on, Kate, didn't you ever just know something, you know, in your gut?
I hate when you call me Kate.
Right, see, good start.
Project Mercury. We had all these young people, so gifted. There was a boy, he could see into rooms through locked doors. There was a girl, she could heal with her hands. My job was to make them weapons.
Putyekin, what was he?
Putyekin? Putyekin? To begin, he had the most stupid little ability. He could explode light bulbs.
He's doing more than blowing up light bulbs.
You know what, light bulbs? This was before we adjusted him. We put a computer chip in his head. And this is 1979, so he's not cheap like you think. No, he's this big. It nearly killed him.
What does the chip do?
Chip extends his power down to the quantum level. Everything around him just dissolves.
He doesn't have a bomb. He is a bomb.
Yeah.
You made a human bomb?
All units, be on the lookout for suspicious activity. Possible explosive devices reported. Code 2.
Do you see that?
Put your hands in the air.
Sir, put your hands in the air now. I'm warning you, put your hands in the air now.
Too late. I'm sorry.
Very, very under arrest. You're Miranda Zero. I could shoot you for espionage just for being here.
We don't have time for this particular game right now. In 18 minutes, something horrible happens in San Francisco.
This Putyekin.
He's having seizures.
You don't have the right to be on government.
I am saving lives. That gives me the right. No government, no border stops me.
You stop him now.
Contact the Secretary of Defense. You tell him I know what happened in Tecumseh, Idaho. You just tell him.
So just call the Secretary of Defense and say one word.
That's right, Tecumseh. There's a cell phone number.
Nobody knows that number.
So call. If I'm bluffing, you can shoot me 2 minutes later. I highly doubt you're that busy.
Watch it.
finish now.
These seizures, are they with electrical surges?
Yes.
The chip, it was never supposed to last this long.
Jenkins! Putekin!
It was the Cold War. When he was sent here, Putekin, he was a weapon.
We can help you.
Stay back.
We're here to help.
Did you ever do something when you were young and stupid?
When he received the signal, he was supposed to...
detonate himself?
Yeah. But Soviet Union fell.
I came here full of hate. But I love this place, these people.
I know.
But the chip sits in brain fluid. It rots. It short circuits, finally.
Stop running, okay? Let me just...
Now, it builds up charge, goes off again and again and again, until finally, one last time, he will overload.
He's already destroying entire city blocks. What happens on the last overload?
The more electrical power he feeds off, the bigger his explosion. So, what happens? Well, where exactly is he?
Substation for the city electrical grid.
A power plant? How bad is this?
Remarkably awful.
You're free to go.
Thank you. I'll need access to your comm center. Sergeyev, come with me. Can he stop the process?
No.
Did he disarm the chip?
No, it's lodged in his skull.
What happened in Tecumseh?
Hey, look. I'm accessing the local control system. Can you help me out? Can you limit the power passing through this room?
I can't. Jenkins fried the local system. But check the schematics.
There are old controls under the abandoned access tunnels.
Okay, fuse breaker from 1947. You can throw it manually. Cut the power under him by 90%.
There's a 90-degree bend here. Maybe 2 feet of clearance here, and then you'd have to go backwards. Oh, this is impossible.
Aren't we the global frequency? Hey, Aleph, I need you to find somebody for me.
What's their name?
Well, I don't know their name.
I know what they do.
Call up NatSat 15 and push the EM spectrum. It should be in place.
That's San Francisco.
Aleph, alert Dr. Finch and Mr. Flynn. Jenkins' explosive power is directly proportional to the strength of nearby electrical fields.
That's not really great.
Because they found him in the middle of a power plant.
Dr. Finch?
I heard.
How big of a boom are we talking about?
He's sitting on gigawatts of power. Most of the electricity for the entire city is passing through this room.
Hey, Sean, check your phone. I sent you the address of the person you requested.
What, is she the only one?
She's the only one close enough.
I've estimated the size of the final blast and the energy available here.
You've got her! You've only got 15 minutes!
Anything we can do.
Can you get close to him?
No, he's already drawing too much power.
But Sean has a plan.
Sean has a plan?
Liz McKenna, you are on the global frequency.
Hey.
Liz, please. I know, it sounds completely and totally crazy. Look, I didn't believe it until I got pulled in.
Your phone?
Yeah, the phone. It's all real. It's completely real. We have 10 minutes before everybody in San Francisco dies. Please. You're needed.
Yeah.
I think I have a solution.
Is this the only way?
Yes.
Kate! Kate Finch, Liz McKenna, UCal Gymnastics, team captain.
What do you need me to do?
Earpiece? We can talk to each other. Liz, squeeze past these pipes. See this breaker? Pull it.
Come on. Here's the entrance.
I'm a little scared.
I'm terrified.
How are you doing, Liz?
Almost there.
Did it.
He'll still overload in 15 to 30 seconds. You can get to him now. Go.
Okay. Liz got me in. What's the plan?
Sean, can you get your hands on a gun?
Yeah, I got a gun.
I'm sorry, but you'll have to destroy the chip while it's still in his head.
No. No. No.
This is not the solution that I would prefer.
I'm not shooting a man in cold blood.
You do understand that if you don't do this, you will die.
Fine.
And Dr. Finch dies. And that young girl you just pulled out of bed dies.
And 3 million other people die.
Sean, this is what we do. We make the choices and we accept the consequences. We walk with blood on our hands so that other people don't have to.
We're out of time! He's gonna blow!
Missed.
Sean? I believe you have something of mine.
Miranda Zero, your real name?
It's the only one you're getting. You just saved 3 million lives.
Nobody will ever know.
Nope. Not what you're doing in San Francisco.
You know, I got fired in Boston.
How would you like to come and work for me?
Like Kate?
Like Dr. Finch. And Mr. Riggs before he died, and many others around the world.
Yeah, I don't know if you noticed, but I had no idea what I was doing.
Yes, you were singularly clueless.
Totally making it up as I went along.
But when nothing is certain, there is no skill more valuable than that of improvisation. I've lost my detective. Be my detective.
I don't trust you.
I've done unspeakable things. But when I formed the Global Frequency, I made a bet that ordinary people will do extraordinary things when given the chance. And I was right. And it's made everything worth it.
Partners?
No, I'm training you.
Oh yeah, you're training me.
So, you have to listen to me and do what I say.
Sure, Kate.
Katrina, or Dr. Finch.
Hey.
Sean Flynn.
Take a bite.
You are on the Global Frequency.